Where is it? There we go.
Marjorie was interviewed by a reporter who asked her a great deal about her reception at Balmoral. But that reporter certainly had more imagination than veracity. And I must say, we were all rather amazed when the result of that interview was published. It read like this. Miss Maud stood upon the little stage at Balmoral Castle, paralyzed with nervousness. Her legs shook beneath her. When suddenly a gentle and womanly voice stole from the royal box, saying, "Courage, my child." It was the Queen. York at Wallach's an awful old theatre it was too. Even then it was supposed to be practically out of the running, so to speak. And the only play that was a success was our new play, Grumpy. But that was simply amazing. It even brought crowded houses to that unfashionable theatre. It was such a great success that we sent back all the rest of our company to England and played Grumpy for the rest of our engagement. And we were still doing as well as ever when we had to return to England to put on the same production at the new St. Martin's Lane. The playhouse had been lent to Mary Tempest while we were away. The English liked Grumpy as much as the Americans, thank goodness, and we were playing it when the war broke out. The 1914 war I'm talking about, of course. Yes, when that war broke out, I realized how old I was. I was 52 and I felt useless and old and over age. And now I'm 85 and still working. Yes? I was broadcasting in my old part of Grumpy only a few weeks ago. Well, I really don't think there's time to go on talking any longer. Next time I hope to tell you something about just one engagement I had in America during those war years when I made one of the early movie pictures, Peer Gynt. But it's a long story and a very active one, and not for now, if you don't mind.